United States is different. They are surrounded by poorer countries.
Yes.
And everybody wants to go to America. And if it's just open like that and catch and release, especially in a pandemic, you can't take care of the whole Mexican country and Honduras and whatever not around it. They don't just come from Mexico. They come from everywhere.
Yes, Haitian.
The Haitians, yes.
Yeah.
And as far as Belize, I don't know, Venezuela and whatever, and Colombia, they're reported from everywhere. America is very rich, that they cannot deal with a sudden influx like this. They cannot take care of other countries' people. They are not at war. They're not in desperation.
Yes, yes.
Maybe they're poorer, but there are poorer countries everywhere. There are always poorer people. It's not a charity. You just tempted people to leave their homes, leave their job, just for an illusion dream. And harming their dignity, and harming the dignity and the reputation of the other so-called lesser countries.
Yes, I understand.
Yeah, let their government take care of them. They can.
They should.
Yeah, they should. Instead of letting them in, and then maybe they cannot speak the language, and then they become like wandering homeless outside. When I was in America, many homeless people, they are not Americans.
Yes, that's right.
They're from Mexico and all that.
Yes.
They're begging on the street. They are not at war, and they are not from a communist country, like under political oppression, nothing. They're just poor. And their country has to help them. Their government has to think of the way to give them work. And if you even want to help them as a charity, then you maybe donate some money every year to those poor people through the government.
Yes.
Or create some jobs or something. You don't have to take care of all the poor from all the poor countries. The Europeans are different. They go in, they speak the language, they work.
Yes.
They contribute. They're not going there just for charity. They're not going there just empty-handed. Even if they go from one country to the next, they're working.
Yes, they're contributing.
They're contributing, and they all speak English, mostly. Even if you go to Spain, for example, there's always somebody who speaks English there.
Yes.
Italy, even. The least learning English, Italy. They still speak English.
Yes.
Yeah, my gardeners speak English. My plumber speaks English in Spain. And my gardener I met in Italy speaks English fluently.
Yes.
And my waiter in my Italian restaurant speaks fluent English.
Incredible.
Yeah. They don't have to learn it in school. They learn it from videos. They learn it from the internet. I asked him, hey, how did you speak English so well? I was thinking you're English or from England. I said, no. You watch movies and subtitles. Yeah, so cool, you know?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. And he was my waiter in one of the restaurants when I now and then go eat a
vegan
pizza. And he gave me some fruit juice drink mix. You can order non-alcoholic
Yes.
fruit punch, other things, some cocktail, but you leave out the alcohol and you can drink.
Yes.
Most of them, you can do that. Most of the cocktails you can order without alcohol. And he speaks fluent English, a good accent, everything. And I say, oh, your country lets you learn English? He say, no, here, mostly don't encourage learning English. Have to speak Italian.
Ah.
Have to be more fluent in their country. Some countries, they are very, very nationalistic.
Yes.
Yeah. French also, they don't like the French people. There's a law even to forbid the French to speak mixed in English.
Oh, wow.
Like you cannot say, oh, je me sens très cool. Means I feel very cool. You cannot say half French, half English like that.
Ah.
Law forbidden. They protect their language. And in Italy, they don't encourage people to study English. Although you can. All my doctors, nurses, they all speak English fluently. But that bar worker told me that he didn't learn not English, the government doesn't encourage. That's what he told me. I did not study well into that. And then I said, then how do you learn English so well? He said, movies. He loves to watch movies with subtitles. Then he speaks English so well. I am surprised at the way he used it. Very elite. And all the police and all that who even come search my house for nothing also speak all English to me.
Wow.
And in the parking lots and in restaurants, everywhere. Everywhere I go, they speak English. It is not that difficult to learn English in Europe because they are more or less like bordering.
Yes.
Borderly neighbors.
Yes.
But the French people, they are very proud of their language. The Italians are the same. They don't allow their citizens to mix.
Ah.
Je suis I'm cool. I'm very cool. You cannot say that. Of course, people still do say that on the street in the coffee, but the law doesn't accept that. I don't mean the police will come and arrest you or anything, but that's a part of the law.
Yes.
You can't mix the French with the English.
That's interesting.
Of course, I also don't like that. Because French is very elegant, you know?
Yes, beautiful.
And if you mix with other languages, then it's not French anymore.
That's right.
And some people don't understand what cool means. What means cool, huh? Is that language? What is it? When people learn the real French and they come to Paris, and some people just say, was that cool? And they will not understand.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, and it dilutes the elegance of the French language.
Yes.
Or Italian, lovely language. I love these. Spanish and French and Italian, oh, they're wonderful languages.
Yes, I like the Italian very much too.
Very musical.
Yes.
When they speak really, especially when a woman speaks, well, you'll fall in love with their language. Oh man, why do I talk so much about what?
You were talking about the immigrants.
Oh, okay, immigrant policy,
yes,
in America. Okay, so Trump told them to stay in Mexico and apply, whoever goes there. So they have the chance to screen.
Yes.
You're not like an open border for charity. You can't take care of all the poor people in the world. You have to take care of your own people first.
Yes.
And then you can help others. If you are in deficit in any way, how can you help?
Yes.
And America right now, it has inflation. You can see that on the news, yeah?
Yes.
The gas price is going up. Food price is skyrocketing. And then, how can you take care of your people? Many Americans are under the poverty line or at the border poverty line.
Yes, yes.
And then they don't even have jobs nowadays. Pandemic, you see?
Yes.
And they force people, mandating that people have to do vaccines.
Yes.
And then they let all the Americans and other people in without vaccines. Nothing. Not even testing. It's on the news. It's official.
Yes, doesn't make sense.
The person at the border or the person who takes care of this immigration problem, they say, we don't even test them. Just let them in.
Yes, doesn't make any sense.
It seems that people are becoming numb to what's going on down here on the border. Not everyone we encounter, we test, only those exhibiting some type of symptoms, and not everybody has symptoms that has it. And we're releasing people out the door day in, day out with actual positive tests for COVID, and more just keep popping up.
Because the president of your country says so. What kind of president is that? He doesn't have any IQ, huh? I would say so. Not to talk about being under influence of the devil, nothing. This kind of president like this is damaging your country.
Yes, yes.
And dragging America down. So this kind of vaccine that he wanted to distribute to other countries first, that's not America first.
That's right.
He's responsible for his country first.
Yes.
And whatever left over, you can give, of course. What for would you give them?
Yes.
So that's what people complain about.
Yes, yes.
And then it's mandating, forcing your citizens to be vaccinated or else, or be kicked out. But let everybody else from every country, don't even know who, don't care who, just let them in with all kind of diseases.
Not yes,
just
that's right.
COVID-19.
Yes.
So all this is causing trouble and death for your people. And this is all for demons to eat if they die.
Terrible.
Yeah, terrible. It's demonic, okay?
Yes.
That's why I'm all out for it, not because of Trump or anything.
Yes, I understand.
I feel so sorry for the Americans. They have been robbed in many ways that they don't even know, even the ones who support the Democratic Party. They have been robbed also. They don't even know. They cannot understand.
Yes, people still don't understand about Trump and how good he is and about any his policies.
Yeah, if they can collect all the information and compare both of them, just like the thing we do on TV, then they would understand somehow who is who.
Yes.
But they don't have time for all this. They have been plucked down with many things, with the jobless, with evictions, because if they don't have jobs, then the government gives them money. It's not enough.
Yes.
And to a certain extent only, and then they shut it, and then let them be in the dark, like putting the child on the highway, like that, suddenly.
Yes.
And then even if the government wants to give continuously, they can't always afford it.
That's right.
I mean, in Vietnam we say if you sit and do nothing and just eat, then even many mountains would be flattened.
Of
course.
Understand.
Of course, no? Only outcome and no income?
That's right.
Mm. Logical, no?
Yes, very logical.
Everybody would understand that. So, you see, now the American people are very, very, very pitiful already.
Yes.
And then they have to want to kill the future citizens. Just a few months and then they become citizens of America.
Yes.
You know, these unborn, millions of them die every year.
Wow.
In America alone. And then they even make more murderous examples now by making it into law to support abortion. And the bill that Biden asked to sign right now and nobody wants to sign is included. They want to take some of that $1 trillion money to pay for abortions.
Ah.
Yeah, more food for the demons. You know, about the money that Biden asked, $3 trillion and all that, some part of it go to the abortion fee.
Yes.
Like the woman who want to abort, we had it free or something, they pay for it and something like that. This is not like generosity. That's why many of the House reps and the Senate did not want to vote for it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's one of the things. And also to pay for the people to become citizens.
Yes, yes.
It's good for voting, but not our charity.
Yes.
Because the Americans, they don't take care of anybody to come in. Of course, it's a good thing, but it's not done in a well-organized way. It will be bad for the country.
Understand.
And about the abortion that they want to pay for, this comes from tax money.
Yes.
If they sign that bill, that means the tax will be paid more. Doesn't matter if they took the money from the public and pay for the private abortions. It's not about private or public. It's just that abortion is a great sin.
Yes.
And anybody who supports it will be punished in hell for murdering, especially killing humans.
Yes.
And then whoever involved in it, even the innocent taxpayers, will also be punished.
Oh.
That is a problem.
Yes.
And then the whole America, Americans, will be in bad judgment, especially now it's a judgment time.
Yes, shared karma.
Yeah. It's not just about the bill and the money, huh?
Yes, understand.
This is the thing people don't understand. I hope they hear me.
Yes.
Otherwise, even if they innocently just pay their duty tax, they will be involved in this killing. If their money, the tax money, is used for free abortion to encourage people to abort, to kill babies.
Yes, understand.
This is a worrisome thing, huh?
Yes.
So more darkness for your country, more weakened strength of your citizens and population. Just take in anybody or smugglers and child abusers or drugs or whatever, but kill your innocent citizens.
That's not right.
Just a few months and they become citizens. They become officially, physically citizens of America. They are Americans.
Yes, yes.
Waiting to come out, not to talk about anything else.
Yes.
So he's killing Americans. And if you kill people, you should go to jail.
Yes, it's murder.
Murder. In America, they put you in jail forever or they execute you. That is the law. And here, legally, openly, they kill millions of Americans in the womb of their mother by supporting, by legalizing abortion.
Yes.
And by even wanting money to give them to do abortions instead of giving the mother the support and the money so that they can give birth and then maybe give up for adoption or something.
That's right.
Americans have enough money. Even if you don't have adoption anywhere, you still can have an orphanage. I mean, governmental orphanage.
And yes.
Raise them up, educate them, and release them out into the world as nurses, as doctors, as engineers, as astronauts, as scientists, as inventors, whatever.
I understand.
They're killing all these potentials, which will be good for your country. And that your own people. I mean, who else can defend your country more than your own people?
That's right.
Not the Mexicans, not the Hondurans, not the whatever else you say. Because blood is thicker than water.
Yes.
You're born in America, of course you defend for your country. You work for your country. You feel you belong there.
Yes.
Yeah. As a child already.
I understand.
And you'll be educated in the American lifestyle. You will sing your anthems. You sweat, vow to protect your country. And you go out and defend your country if you have to.
Yes.
Yeah. How are they going to have more soldiers as good as the Marines or special forces sent to Afghanistan?
Yes.
How are you going to have them all to defend your country in case of any war or anything? Or even to train them, but then let them go out to help with flood trouble or any disaster in your country, or distributing food when people are in need?
Definitely, yes.
When disaster befalls them or something like that?
Yes.
How are you going to have all these young people if you kill all these babies?